Hey, what's up guys? Thanks for tuning in. If you're watching this video in particular, chances are you probably did not have a great day. Because this is going to be on replacing the K400 cable, because I kinked it after going into a lift station that they didn't tell me about. And that's just part of the job sometimes. You never know what's down the way. It's unfortunate when this kind of stuff happens, but the problem got fixed and the machine's still good. We just got to swap the cable. Look at this mess though. It was an emergency call too. I think I got the call at 10:30. It was like 2 when I got back. So I got the cable kind of stuck. That's what we got. No coming back from that. So what I'm gonna do is cut it with a angle grinder. So hopefully we can still salvage. I mean, there's still a decent amount of cable in there. Ready. So I don't know if I'll have any use for that. Definitely gonna save the tip.
That's what she said.
Don't you dare.
Yeah, no coming back from that. Won't even go back in the machine. So I think I've got some little channies, some baby chans. The nice thing too, I've already had to hook this up once. I know you can just pull the cable out and there's a little clamp that holds the bottom side on. So once we get the cable, I'll be curious to see how much a new cable is, but I think I paid $400 for this machine and I got it used. So, but it's already making me make some good money. Now at least it's got a little nub, you know, when it's spinning around in the pipe, it'll still grab things. Again, I don't know what I'm gonna use for that. The whole point is, actually, let's do a quick test. I don't know how much is still on there. I'll flip this over. We'll run this out. Oh yeah, this will still be a great machine for 2-inch kitchen or good cable. Might just keep that machine how it is. Because for kitchen lines, the little claw's gonna work just fine. Yeah, now I'm torn. I might just keep that machine how it is. Maybe I'll order a cable and just do a video on it for people that wanna see. You know what? Let me just kill 2 birds with 1 stone because I know for a fact. Let me take this camera off so we can see in there. Yep, you see? It's just a little bracket that's got 2 nuts back here, two flatheads it looks like. So, you know, you just move your machine around. Those 2 screws right there are what hold that bracket in. And that's what keeps it from flying out and from twisting up on itself. Yeah, that's a good shot. So that's the bracket. Literally, to swap it out, you would just pull that bracket, take the cable out, put the new cable end in, maybe put another glove on. I don't even know why I bother. Doing this stuff, you realize, like, no matter how clean you try to be, it's just everywhere. Yeah, now we got our new little hook. Still functions. Cool. So the complaint was that it wouldn't stop running. As soon as I pulled the lid, it's one of these power flushes. And the one that scared the shit out of you, you're not expecting it. And I've never tried to rebuild this, so I just replaced it just like with kitchen faucets and lab faucets.